हेलो व्यूज, वेलकम टू माय चैनल पीसी जियो किम्बरलाय अ सोर्स ऑफ डायमंड्स। इन दिस वीडियो अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू हैव अ इंपॉर्टेंट स्कॉलरशिप फॉर अ स्टैंडर्ड 6 to 12 एंड दिस स्कॉलरशिप इज स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय एचडीएफसी बैंक। द एचडीएफसी बैंक इज स्पॉन्सरिंग द स्कॉलरशिप फॉर 6 to 12 स्टैंडर्ड ऑन द नेम HDFC Bank Parivartan's ECS Scholarship for Class 6 to 12 Standard for the year 2021 to 22. I am Dr. Sajid Ondekar, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Geology, AKI, Pune College of Arts, Science, Commerce, CAM, Pune, Maharashtra, India. HDFC Bank Parivartan is, this is the scholarship has given for the various classes. Now, in this video, we are going to see a class 6 standard to class 12 standard. And the last date for this scholarship is given, mentioned on the portal is 31st July 2021. So, time is there. Those who are there watching now, just see if your the applicant is there. You can apply for your children's are there, you can apply for them, or in your family or family friends or in your groups, if anyone is there in a standard 6 to 12 who is coming under a low income family group, that is the annual income is less than 2,50,000. Yes, if it is the income is less than 2,50,000 and their child is studying in between 6 to 12 standard, for them the HDFC is sponsoring a scholarship on the name HDFC Bank Parivartan's ECS scholarship. So I request the first and foremost to all the viewers, the NGOs, please transfer this scholarship to the right deserving candidates. Because you know everyone in the slum areas, because this will be income which will be less than 2.5 lakh is there, that is 2,50,000. They will be living in a slum areas or those areas where income is low one. So you know these families very well. Approach them and this is the best scholarship for them to apply. So the intention, the aims of HDFC is saying that he wanted to promote or support the meritorious and needy students belonging to the underprivileged section of the society. And presently the student has to be there in 6th standard to 12th standard. And there is another scholarships are there. So everyone know the bank, HDFC Bank, this is the top private bank is there. And it is giving a scholarship on this educational crisis scholarship, that is ECS, merit come means based scholarship is there. And the last date is, already it is written everywhere, 31st July 2021. So you should not be forget. Now the next one, eligibility criteria for this scholarship. First one, the applicant should be Indian national. He should be studying in the current 6 to 12 standard in a private or government aided schools. The applicant must be pass the previous examination with at least 55% marks. If he is there in the 6th standard, that means he has passed the 5th standard with the 55% mark. If he is in the 10th standard, pass with the 55%, now he is in the 11th standard, he is going to get the at least 55%. Those who are passed the 11th standard with the 55% now taken admission in the 12th standard. So the minimum condition for the marks is 55%. The second very important one, the family's income, the annual family income should be less than 2,50,000 rupees. 2,50,000, these two conditions, no reservations are there, only these two conditions has to be fulfilled by that particular deserving candidate so that he will be eligible. But this scholarship is all India level. So from all India, the scholarships students will be apply for the scholarship. Then the company will be set to make a merit list on the basis of these two criteria, and if you qualify within the whatever the stimulated quota is there, in this quota, if you get it out, then you will be getting the scholarship from 6th standard to 12th standard, rupees 35,000, and 75,000 rupees is there from 12 onwards for the graduate, undergraduate and postgraduate courses. Now, what are the documents are required here? The first and important one, passport size photograph. All these are the, you have to make the online. So all digital, you should have the high resolution scan copies, your passport size photograph last year or last year. If you have last year mark sheet, due to some problem, you don't get the mark sheet of last year, then you have to upload the last year mark sheets. Then the next very important one document, identity proof. Everyone should have Aadhaar card or voter ID or driving license. So the students are there who are studying in 6th to 12th standard. So voter ID and driving license is not there. So they should have the Aadhaar card. Then the very important one, where they are taken the admission fee receipt or admission letter or institution ID proof, or ultimately if you don't have this one, then at least bona fide certificate that you are taking admission in so and so college or in a school. Then the next one, applicant's bank passbook and the cancel check. So the money will be directly transferred through the electronic transfer e-vault. So they should have the bank passport and cross cancel check and income proof. And this income certificate should be given by or approved by, issued by Gram Panchayat, Ward Councillor, Sarpanch or SDM, DM, CO, Tahsildar. And the last one, they have to make the affidavit. Yes. So here we have given you the link. So you can go on that link. Otherwise, if you have any problem on this link, directly you can go and visit the website of buddyforstudy.com, and on that you can make your own account, Facebook account or your mobile, or whether your email IDs, you can make an account, and from that account you can apply for these particular scholarship. Last date, remember, last date is 31st July. And I request all the viewers and the subscribers, as well as I'm going to upload this one into the Facebook various scholarship portals and the NGOs. So NGOs are very, very important one. They can go and they know every family, those who are living in that particular low income areas, that is the whose income is less than 2,50,000, they know very well. So they can try to fill out the scholarships of these particular students who require the financial assistance in the form of scholarship to pursue their education, continue their education to make the minimum dropouts. I hope the message from my side is clear, that it should be make the awareness,